Especially not the way you want to go out, I imagine.
Yeah, it's tough. It just shows you, you know, you have to come out, you know, ready every week, and any team can do anything. So, I mean, you just come in every week, you know, going 100% and try to get your best odds.
Chauncey, I know it's a tough loss. I also know how you want to end your career here, Kenny, but you got a short week between now and Nebraska. I don't know if you normally would like that, but after a couple tough defeats, you almost kind of welcome a short week. How are you going to prepare for that? Is that going to be any different? How's that going to work for you?
Yeah, it's a little accelerated. So, I mean, tonight, some guys probably have to watch the game here, you know, finish up and, you know, understand mistakes, understand the positives. And then I think tonight some of the guys might, you know, be able to move on to Nebraska, look at some of their tape, just get a, you know, a general understanding of what they can do. Because, I mean, it's, as I said, it's an accelerated week. So, definitely, your body's going to have to be physically ready. It's going to definitely need, you know, a lot of sleep this week and be able to, you know, stay on task with your stuff. But the thing is, we don't have school, so guys should be able to put that extra time in.
Good luck to you for your future.
How emotional was it for you at the beginning of the game, and what was running through your mind?
Yeah, seeing my family out there, my two parents. You know, it's good to see them out there, but you never want that day to come. You know, you want to keep on playing football here, especially at a place like this. So, you know, it sucks, but at the same time, you know, it's a great accomplishment to, you know, go through this university, you know, play football here, and just, you know, create the amazing relationships that I've created and everybody else has created through our football team.
What happened on those first two Purdue possessions of the second half?
We got a couple of big passes. They had one behind them, and threw it to their guy 21, who was you know, a pretty good player. And the execution came down to execution. You know, doing your fundamental stuff.
How do you explain the drop off the past 2 weeks? It seems like an energy level and execution, like you're saying, on all three phases.
Yeah, it's something, you know, we need to shore up during the week. I think it's you know, it comes down to preparation before, you know, the battle's won before it's fought. So I think that's the thing that Coach Swiss talks about. Multiple different coaches on the team talk about that. And it's just a thing, you know, you have to work hard during the week if you want to come out on a Saturday or, you know, even this coming Friday, come out with a victory, because, you know, the Big Ten's tough. It's a bunch of good competition. You never know each week.
Have you sensed any drop off or change in practice, or how have you, I guess, gauged that coming into these last weeks?
No, I haven't seen anything. Nothing that you know, made me scared or made me you know, feel better. I thought we were been practicing pretty well. I thought this week went well. I thought we, you know, executed the plays that we needed to execute. But you know, it comes down to Saturday. It comes down to, you know, you need to be ready for the Saturday game. You can do all the execution on, you know, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, but it matters on Saturday. So you have to have a combination of both.
Josie, you as a captain, a leader, what do you do in the next couple of days? Anything different to get the team more focused, perhaps?
I don't know. I mean, I think you just kind of you talk about it. I mean, after the game, you know, we broke it down. I talked a little bit to the team about, you know, where do you want to be? Where do you want to be at the end of the season? Do you want to go to Detroit? Or do you want to go somewhere, you know, where it's kind of warm, at least? So you really think about the end goal, kind of look in that and get in perspective for the guys. Maybe the young guys that don't understand it as much, or, you know, haven't seen this, you know, in past years, just try to, you know, understand what can happen. And we can still finish the season strong. We can still, you know, finish with two wins at the end of the season.
From your perspective, I mean, how do you explain what happened against Ohio State, beyond little things, to what's happened these last 2 weeks, just as a team?
Yeah, I don't know. That's a great question. It's something we need to figure out. You know, how we energized and how we had that much, you know, momentum during that game, and now, you know, we're up and down. We're the roller coaster right now, and we need to be able to, you know, sustain success and be able to keep on doing it. It's all about the execution. You know, a couple drop balls, we had a couple missed picks too today. So I mean, it just comes down to, you know, going out there and, you know, doing your job.
Okay, thanks, Joseph.